Pilot operated check valves. Normal check valve has only two ports, port A and port B. Port A is inlet port, port B is outlet port. The fluid can flow from A to B in case of normal check valve. In the reverse direction, the fluid can't flow. That is, from B to A, fluid can't flow in normal check valves. Normal check valve is open for forward direction and closed in the reverse direction. Whereas a pilot operated check valve has an additional port called pilot port P. By the application of pilot pressure through the pilot port P, the check valve which was closed earlier is made to open, or the check valve which was open earlier is made to close. Accordingly, there are two types of pilot operated check valves. One is pilot to open check valve and the other is pilot to close check valve. Look here, this is normal check valve. It is open in A to B direction. In B to A direction, it is not open. It won't allow fluid to flow in B to A direction. It is closed for B to A direction. Pilot to open check valve is open when pilot pressure is given for B to A direction also. A to B direction, working fluid, that is fluid can flow easily. And B to A direction, fluid can't flow, but if pilot pressure is given, then fluid can flow. In the same way, pilot to close check valve. A to B, fluid can flow. B to A, fluid can't flow. B to A, it is closed for flow, and A to B, it is open for flow. But if pilot pressure is given, then the valve is closed for A to B direction also. A to B, fluid can flow, but if pilot pressure is given to P, then fluid can't flow from A to B. And B to A is closed, of course. Fluid can't flow from B to A. This is construction of pilot to open check valve. If fluid supply is given to A, then the spool, the conical poppet, will shift off from its seat and it is open for flow to port B. And if supply is given to port B, then the valve closes. Fluid can't flow to A. Valve closes and fluid cannot flow to A. But if pilot pressure is given, then this small piston, it will push the spool, conical poppet, so that passage is made and fluid can flow from B to A. A to B, oil can flow. B to A, oil can't flow in case of check valve. But if pilot pressure is given, then oil can flow from B to A also. And this is diagram of pilot to close check valve. Now, if supply is given to B, then the valve closes and it can't flow to, oil can't flow to A. But if supply is given to A, then the conical poppet will move away from its seat and oil can flow to B. But if pilot pressure is given, like this, then the conical poppet will sit on its seat and it won't allow oil to flow from A to B. A to B, flow is stopped by applying pilot pressure to P. So this circuit, this is fail-safe circuit or actuator locking circuit. This is an example for application of pilot to open check valve. This is the pilot to open check valve. It is used for locking this load or locking the cylinder to avoid creeping of the load in downward direction. Look at this circuit diagram. This is 4x3 closure center mid position valve. In first position, there will be connection from P to A and P to T, due to which oil flows to A port and weight is lifted. And in the second position, P to B, A to T connection is there, weight is lower. To stop the cylinder or to stop the weight in its position, anywhere between the two end positions, we use closed center mid position. When we keep the lever in mid position, the weight should stop. Weight should stop at its position. But the problem is, there will be very small amount of internal leakage in the valves. There will be leakage of oil between the spool and the valve. body. There is leakage, very small amount, through the wall, and oil flows back to tank from A to T. So due to which the weight starts creeping in downward direction slowly. To avoid this creeping of load in downward direction, we use fail-safe circuit. This is fail-safe circuit. In first position, there is connection from P to A and B to T. Oil flows to the cylinder through the check valve. Weight is lifted. Oil on the other side of the piston flows out from B to T back to tank. When we keep the lever in the second position, P to B, A to T connection is there. Oil flows to rod end port of the cylinder. Piston will move in downward direction and the check valve remains open because there is pilot pressure. This is pilot to open check valve. Oil flows from A port to T port of the valve and it flows back to tank and the weight starts moving in downward direction. When we keep the lever in its middle position to stop this load, there is connection from A and B of cylinder to tank. That is, both line A and line B will lose the pressure due to which the check valve gets closed and check valve will not allow oil to flow through it and hence the weight will stop at its position. The cylinder is locked. Weight will not creep in downward direction because the check valve will not allow even a small drop of oil to flow through it. And this circuit is regenerative circuit using pilot to close check valve. In this circuit, we use a check valve here. This check valve is pilot to close check valve. In first position of the lever of 4x2 direction control valve, P to A, B to T connection is there. Oil can flow from P to A and cylinder will extend. Oil which is coming out of the rod end port will join with the pump discharge. It is flowing again back to this head port. It will join with the pump discharge and the rate of flow of oil which is going into the cylinder is the sum of pump discharge and the rate of flow of oil which is coming out of the cylinder, that small q. So q plus small q, that much of flow is going to the cylinder, that's why the cylinder speed is increased. The speed or velocity is increased, but the force will be less. Force is reduced because previously the whole area of piston was available for the application of pressure, but now there is pressure from both directions. So if F1 is the force which is acting in rightward direction and F2 is the force which is acting in leftward direction. So the net force is F. It is the difference between F1 and F2. So this is pressure into area of piston rod only. So that's why the force is reduced. So this concept is explained while explaining regenerative circuits. You can refer the video of either regenerative valves or regenerative circuits for understanding this clearly. In the regenerative circuits, the velocity or speed of the piston is increased at the cost of force developed. So here, regenerative extension is there. When we keep the lever in the first position, the cylinder extends with higher speed. And when we keep the lever in the second position, P to B, A to T connection is made. Oil from the pump flows to port B and rod end of the cylinder. From head end of the cylinder, oil flows back to tank. The oil which is coming out from the pump, from B port, it can't flow here because when there is pressure in this line, okay, this pressure, due to this pressure, the pilot to close check valve will close. It won't allow oil to flow in this direction. Okay, that's why pump discharge, totally the pump discharge should flow to rod end of the cylinder. So that is the function of pilot to close check valve. During extension, there is no pilot pressure here. So that's why this valve is open. But during retraction, since there is pilot pressure here, there is pressure, that pressure is acting on the pilot, that's why this valve will close. During extension, there is no pilot pressure, that's why this valve is open and oil which is coming out of the cylinder is going to head end of the cylinder and it is joining with the pump discharge and regenerative circuit is possible.